guest is an old friend who we love seeing back on the desk. Would you please welcome Peter Helliar?
Yes. Yeah.
Thanks, guys. Thank you.
That one?
Okay, good.
Hey, so good to see you for the first time in 2024.
2024! Do you have clips? you're teasing me, Wally.
Sorry, that's all we got. I hear, though, that you, since we've seen each other, you've got some life-changing announcement. Oh. Is this true? I'm ready.
Are you referring to my name change?
Is that what it is?
Yeah, basically. Yeah, I'm now officially. I'm officially Pete Helliar now. Officially, legally, I've always been Peter Helliar, and then I was in the jungle, and Julia Morris, who I've known for many years, would come to me in the jungle and say, Peter. I'm like, who the bloody who she's talking to? Like, my friends call me Pete. People in the street call me Pete.
Yeah.
So I'm there, and I realise there'll be a period of adjustment for everybody.
Yeah.
You know? Like, you know, Pink's mum didn't call her Pink on the first day. Right. It was Alicia. She's like, Mum, it's Pink. Yeah.
Do you have any attachment to the name Peter, though? Like, the full name?
Yeah. Not just, really. Like, it's only if Mum calls me that, I have it. But it's just a showbiz thing. You know, Emma Stone, likely Oscar winner Emma Stone, her name was Emily Stone.
Right.
Oh, yeah. Right. Okay.
Rove McManus.
Yeah.
The real name is Rove Mussolini.
Wow. I can see why
he changed it, because he's the nicest guy in the world. Yeah.
Are you ever going to yearn for the R again, wake up, and Peter, like someone that lost a limb? Are you ever going to have like a ghost R?
A phantom R.
Well, now that you put it in my head, maybe I will, Nick. Thank you.
Now, Pete, I want to talk about the poster for your new stand-up show. What is going on? It's a bizarre look. What's happening? What's going on
here?
That's just the inner me, basically. I've let myself out and, you know, 10 years on the project in a suit, and I thought, let's just bust out now. And that's me. That's the, you know, it's Pete Helliar gives zero flips. I've got to be very careful. Okay. I've told you many times.
So that's the name of your new show.
Yeah.
You've been off TV now for about a year or so. How flipping hard is it not to swear right now?
It's flipping hard. There were many, many warnings and signs in the green room, but it's my new life philosophy. If you give zero flips, you know, you just feel, I don't know, more relaxed, to be honest. Like, I've been doing some pretty crazy stuff. I went down. I'm not sure if the cops are watching, but let's
tune off for a bit.
I went down to Coles recently.
Oh,
yeah. And I took a Woolies bag. Oh. Yes.
Oh.
Yes. They can't do anything about it.
Ruthless.
And then I went to Baker's Delight. I ordered a loaf. They said, do you want a sandwich or toast slice? I said, toast slice, even though I know I'm using it for sandwiches.
Yeah,
yes, zero flips. Yes.
This man doesn't care.
He doesn't
care. Are you seeing out people out and about in life living by this same philosophy?
Oh, they're out in the wild. I saw a guy. This is dead set, 100% true. I was waiting to get on the aeroplane. The guy in front of me, I would say at age group, I'd say he was a millennial. He had the dressing gown on and some slippers. And he had a sausage roll. This is lining up to get on the aeroplane.
Okay. Wait, he's got a sausage roll.
Sausage roll
on a plane.
In a brown paper bag.
That's weird. That's
then
very weird.
His tiger's still going.
Then he's got like a sachet of sauce.
Okay.
And this is how he ate it, okay?
Oh.
Took a bite of his sausage roll, okay? Gave it a little chew, just to get it going.
Yeah.
Then sucked the sauce into it, and then this thermo mixed his mouth. And at first, I was like, it was a roller coaster of emotions.
Yeah.
I was revolted.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, got that.
Impressed.
Yes.
Yeah.
And then aroused.
Yeah.
I was.
That's
real.
The standard Pete Helliar trifecta.
Most shows that But is this guy?
I'm actually quite impressed. I feel like maybe we should all go and try that. I feel like you're starting something, Pete, and everyone at home will be like, next time I have a sausage roll, I'm going to try that thing.
Well, you could take ketchup.
I can't take the credit. I was a witness to this man's genius.
Yeah.
And another bloke, I think the Aussiest bloke I know, my cousin. Okay. Simo. Okay.
Simo.
Yeah,
Simo.
Good start. You just mentioned a bloke drinking sauce.
Yeah.
So, if Simo's more Australian,
Simo
than that.
Better, okay. So Simo had a date a little while ago, rocks up to the apartment of this lady.
Oh.
Did he take flowers? No.
No.
Did he take chocolates? No, because he gives zero flips. What he takes, without a word of a lie, is a bottle of Jim Beam and a box of Cheezels.
Oh.
No.
Right, what?
Like, the only way he could have given less flips if the first words he said were, pull my finger. Like, that's the only way. But, I mean, like, that's him living... That's a good strategy. Set the bar low.
And then there's only one way to go.
My Bridget and I took her to the theatre and then we had a nice... I could have saved $300 if I went to her house with a bottle of Frangelico and some Doritos. That would have been much cheaper.
But you can say it's genius, but how did the date actually go?
They literally... are getting married next month.
What?
They are getting married next month. He put a ring on it, and that ring was puppy cheese. Yes.
What about your kids? You've got three kids.
Yes.
Are they given zero flips? Yeah. What's their attitude to life? Surely.
Do I give them zero flips, or do they give me zero flips?
Yeah.
They're pretty relaxed. Okay, they're 21, 19, and 15. So eventually. We have to remember we still got a parent, 15-year-old. do what you like. Oh, no, hang on, you're 15.
Yeah. I didn't know that. Yeah. I was just trying to get mine to 7 and 5, and then you go, you boys are right.
Yeah. 18's a good ballpark, I reckon.
Yeah. All right. Yeah.
Pete, have you been having to do a bit of hustling or anything in your time away from the desk? Away from, you're on the comedy tour circuit now. What are you doing at comedy festivals?
Yeah, I'm basically, you heard about my back alley. Good. I mean, last year was a great year. I did Taskmaster, which was great. We'll be on Channel 10 very soon. I've been travelling. I'm at the Comedy Festival. I'm about to start the tour. We're sharing a venue.
We are. You're before me.
Yes.
So you're opening
I hear you've been telling people. What have you been telling people?
Well, I've been telling people that I took your job and now you're opening for me.
Yeah. Now, I'm doing my show and then a different audience comes in for your show, yes I am opening.
And also, you also let me go after you because of time constraints, so you were very nice to me.
Oh, no, don't.
Hang on, so Peter.
Don't ruin the joke with some sincerity.
That sounds like a man who gives flips.
Yeah. You know? Of course.
Yeah.
And are you happy about Taskmaster?
Oh, I'm thrilled. I can't wait for people to see it. I'm not exactly sure when it's going to come out, but it is phenomenal. So much fun, great cast, and a lot of fun.
There's Jim Beam and cheese. Also, I can figure a date out.
Only.
A sausage roll and some sauce. You've got to suck it through.
Well, Peter's taking his new show right across the country over the next few months. The link to tickets is on our website. Would you please thank Peter? Yeah. Peter Helliar, not Peter.